at the NGMA, and we're at the retrospective of Yusuf Arakkal's lifetime work, really. It's being showcased at the NGMA, and we have the privilege of talking to Sara, his dear wife, who has put this whole retrospective together painstakingly, working for a whole year. So, Sara,
yes,
can you tell us what grabbed your attention the most in Yusuf's thought process of his painting?
If I say I have to go back to my younger age, because from the age of 8, I'm seeing him painting, drawing. At the age of 16, I got married, so... And from then, I'm seeing his works. Sometimes I say, no, this is not good. But later, I enjoyed his works, different series, different subjects. Then I involved myself. Okay, then after his passing away, then I have to take a lot of time to think whether I can bring this retrospective, because this is like a memory journey of him. Doing, getting all the 45 years of his lifetime work. I wanted to show people, the art lovers, well-wishers, artists, students, you name it, everybody. I want them to enjoy his 45 years of lifetime works. And NGMA really did, supported me, cooperated me with me. They came and selected painstakingly, 2-3 days they came, and I also don't know what is happening now. But painstaking, this pain, you will see how it has come out. Beautifully it has come out. I'm really grateful to NGMA to support me this way, this much. I'm overwhelmed. I don't know what to say yet. And Arundhati, whenever I call, she supports me. Whatever it is, she comes.
No, it is really the art. It is what Yusuf has created. It is what he created with you around him also. I mean, there is a contribution of the wife who looks after all the idiosyncrasies of the artist. And he flowers. And today, you are here. You've given us this retrospective. So thanks.
Talk about art and Yusuf Arakkal and his retrospective.
ಹೆಸರು ಶಿಬು ಅರಕ್ಕಲ್ ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಯೂಸುಫ್ ಅರಕ್ಕಲ್ ಅವರು ಮಗ. ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿ ಸಾರಾ ಅರಕ್ಕಲ್ಲು ಅವರು ಈ ರೆಟ್ರೋಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆದು ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಎನಲ್ಲಿ, ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲರಿ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಆರ್ಟ್. ಇವಾಗ ಇದು ಅವ್ರದ್ದೊಂದು ಆಸೆಯಾಗಿತ್ತು ಹೋದ 6 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ, ಇವಾಗ ಫುಲ್ಫಿಲ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 250 ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆದು, ಓವರ್ 50 ಇಯರ್ಸು ಏನೋ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಬಂದು ನೋಡಬೇಕು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಷನ್ನ. ಇದು ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಷನ್, ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಒಂದು ರೆಟ್ರೋಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆದು. ಅವರು ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರಿಂದ ಇರೋ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್. ಅವರು ಕೇರಳದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರು ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ನೇ ತಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಬಾಳಿ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ತೀರು ಹೋದರು. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಬಂದು ನೋಡಬೇಕು. ಇದು ತುಂಬ ಒಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರೋ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಷನ್ ಅದು. ಪೇಂಟಿಂಗ್ಸು, ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ಸು, ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಅವರು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಿರೋ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ ಸ್ಕಲ್ಪ್ಚರು ಇದೆ. ಅದು ಒಂದು 1956 ಫಿಯೆಟ್ ಮಿಲಿಸೆಂಟು. ಅದು ನಮ್ಮದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾರಲೇಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸೆಂಟಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವರು ಮಾರಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಇಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು. ಬಟ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫೈನಲಾಗಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಕಾಪರ್ ಸ್ಕಲ್ಪ್ಚರಾಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದು ತುಂಬಾ ಒಂದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ನೋಡೋಕ್ಕೆ. ಅದು ತುಂಬ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟಾಗಿದೆ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವಿಂದ. ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರು ಬರಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೋಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಷ್ಟ. ಅದು ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಷನ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ತೋರ್ಸೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ನಾವು. ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತುಂಬಾ ಒಂದು ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ.
From realism, bright colored realism, to somber expressionism, which was the result of probably the exposure to other arts and artists and his training in Baroda. I'm not sure, probably Saraji would know better how this change occurred, but it did. and his identification with the downtrodden, with the suffering humanity that you will see today. Also, as someone who spent his childhood in Kerala, he was sensitive to nature also, because there were flower studies. I don't know whether any of his flower studies are in this exhibition or not, but he did paint flowers also. Have a look at the works, and we thank both Nazmin ji and Sara ji for giving us this opportunity to revisit Yusuf and see his works. Thank you very much. I am grateful to the NGMA for giving me this opportunity to Yusuf. Thank you very much.
I got this telegram to show to my mother and said, I won the national award. And my mother's reaction was, that's all very good, but have you got your salary? That may seem funny, and it is funny, but it shows you the kind of responsibility she took for us, for her husband, for her son, and for us as a unit. And that's what makes their journey together such a special one. The other little story is that, and my mother will have to correct me here, I've never seen my dad ever paint after sunset. It's probably because he preferred painting using daylight. Probably, I'm not really sure, but I never did ever see him paint after sunset. But this one time he came home in the evening and he desperately wanted to paint this painting. And we lived in a really small house, like a really, really small house given to my dad by the HL. We lived in the HL quarters at that point, but a really tiny house. It was literally one bedroom house. And lo and behold, the power went. So what did my mother do? She went in and she brought a whole bunch of candles and lit candles around the edge of the room. And there was just enough space for my dad to put the candles down on the floor and paint. And he painted for about 2 hours, finished the canvas, as he would normally do. That's not exceptional for him. And nothing was said, no drama, and we all went to sleep. Got up the next day morning, and we saw this painting. And I think we all were just completely gobsmacked. We were like, we couldn't believe that he painted that in candlelight. And that, I know for a fact, is a painting that my mother will never let go of.